People give attention, a story you shall hear. It is of the king and my lord Delamere. A quarrel arose in the Parliament House concerning the taxes to be put in force. I wonder that James, our good king, so many hard taxes upon the poor should bring. So many hard taxes, as I have heard them say, makes many a good farmer to break and run away. Such a rout has been in the Parliament, I hear, betwixt a Dutch lord and my Lord Delamere. He said to the king as he sat on the throne, if it please you, my liege, to grant me a boon. Oh, what is thy boon? Come, let me understand. It's to have all the poor men you have in your land. I'll take them to Cheshire, and there I will sow both hemp seed and flax seed, and hang them in a row. It's better they be hanged and stopped short their breath than for your majesty to starve them to death. Then up starts a Dutch lord, as we do here, and he says, thou proud Jack, to my Lord Delamere, thou ought to be stabbed. And he turned him about for affronting the king in the Parliament House. Then up starts his grace, the Duke of Devonshire, who said, I will fight for my Lord Delamere. He is underage, as I'll make it appear, so I'll stand in defence of my Lord Delamere. A stage then was built, and to battle they went. To kill or to be killed, it was their intent. The very first blow, as we understand, Devonshire's rapier went back to his hand. Then he waited a while, but not a word spoke, till on the king's armour his rapier he broke. Oh, then he stepped backward, and backward stepped he, and then stepped forward my Lord Willoughby. He gave him a rapier, and thus he did say, play low, Devonshire, there's treachery I see. He knelt on his knee and gave him his death wound. With that the Dutch lord fell dead on the ground. The king called his soldiers, and thus he did say, bring Devonshire down, take the dead man away. He answered, my liege, I've killed him like a man, and I'm resolved to see what clothing he's got on. Oh, treachery, as I well may say, it was your intent, O king, to take my life away. He fought in your armour while I fought him bare, and thou, king, shalt win it before thou dost it wear. I neither do curse king, parliament, or throne, but I wish every honest man may enjoy his own. The rich men do flourish with silver and gold, while poor men are starving with hunger and cold. And if they hold on as they have begun, they'll make little England pay dear for a king.